let's take a look at the best and worst booking of the week in pro wrestling. We will start with the bottom four, the worst booking of the week. And then we start on Raw, the booking of Gargano versus Omos.
I would love to have this rematch with you tonight so I could beat you, but unfortunately, this week, I injured myself doing a TikTok. Since I could not compete, I found you a worthy opponent.
The booking didn't help Gargano here fighting the Giant, but I don't think Gargano helped himself either, making it look bad at the end when he goes to drop an elbow on Omos and kind of botches it for Omos to catch him on the throat for like a chokeslam type thing. Yeah, I think this match made Gargano look bad, so I didn't like the booking of it in the first place, because in recent weeks we're seeing Gargano being booked more as a character rather than just this good wrestler, so that's good for him. But then to book him against Omos, I get it, it makes Miz look like a heel, he chicken shits himself out of the match and makes Omos fight Gargano, but I don't like the booking overall for Gargano here. I think it made him look bad. At number three is on Dynamite and the new storyline out of nowhere between Jade Cargill and Kiera Hogan.
Let's go.
Not you. Address this.
Kiera, while the camera's here, I'm going to need you to sign this. Yeah, please just sign this. This is stating that you are aware that you did not live up to your end of the agreement as far as the baddies are concerned. Jade Cargill will no longer need your services.
Kiera Hogan has been a part of the baddies for quite a while now. There was just not enough build for me as to Kiera Hogan getting kicked out of the baddies by Jade Cargill here. It makes for a new feud, and Kiera Hogan's probably going to be a face in it against Jade Cargill. But with no build to it, it's just bad booking. Every story is better with a proper build, and this story did not get a proper build.
Theory, you don't believe me? You need some proof? Why don't you pick up your little cell phone, call Cody Rhodes, you ask him how his rehab is going. Yeah, you say, Cody, is it a good idea to pick a fight with Seth freaking Rollins? You let me know what he says.
Number two is the Seth Rollins character. I feel like it's starting to get lost because him as a heel with this character, he seems like this maniacal, the Riddler-like, over-the-top cartoon villain. But the crowd is starting to cheer him. So he's kind of a tweener in between a heel and a face right now. And I don't think they don't know where to write for him. They don't know which way to make him go, if he's going to become more and more of a face or continue to be a heel, because he continues to cut heel promos, but he's getting cheers. You know, maybe he's the usual typical anti-hero heel that we always see in pro wrestling these days. But I think it kind of ruins the character. I think Rollins has done a good job being entertaining as his character. I just wish it would become fleshed out more. At number one, though, it goes to Tony Khan's booking.
Would you like to hear from your new world champion, Mr. Freeman? Well, you will hear from him, as he will be next week.
First of all, MJF is your new champion, and he's not even there. And we see later on the show, their new women's champion, Jamie Hayter, doesn't even get to talk. So this is already a loss of momentum in the booking by Tony Khan. One of Tony Khan's worst traits as a booker is not being able to be consistent with his booking. And we're seeing that again already here with his two new champions. And to make matters worse, we have Regal just turned on Moxley at the pay-per-view, and of course Moxley wants to come and confront him. But instead of a good confrontation, we get a very awkward confrontation where Bryan Danielson runs to the ring and gets between them. He cuts this odd promo about his problems with his father and how William Regal helped him love his father during his father's last few years of life. It didn't hit with the smark crowd in Chicago. They kind of turned on this segment, and I think it just made Bryan Danielson look awkward. It didn't make this dynamic intriguing enough for me, and was just all around weird booking by Tony Khan to start Dynamite. But let's get to the best booking of the week in pro wrestling.
Due to the extent of the injuries to the AEW Women's Champion Thunder Rosa and the uncertainty of when she could return to action, AEW and Thunder Rosa have reached a mutual agreement.
At number four, is AEW finally ending their interim championship stuff that they've been trying, where if a champion gets injured, the new person who gets the title is just an interim champion and not a real champion. This is something UFC tried in a real sports league, and it didn't even work in a real sports league. It takes away from star power if you're calling a champion an interim champion. So they finally get it right here, and yes, of course, there's speculation of all the backstage drama between Thunder Rosa and Britt Baker, but finally taking the interim title away and making Jamie Hayter the real champion instead of Thunder Rosa still being the real champion and there being interim champions was the right call.
North American Championship match. This will be your first and your last title defense. I'm the new standard as the NXT North American Champion, and I will risk everything to keep it.
At number three comes from NXT, and that is the way they built up this Wesley and Carmelo Hayes feud. I like that Carmelo Hayes was this pretty cocky, dominant heel champion for a while, and Wesley is kind of this new underdog champion, finally cementing himself as a single superstar. I thought that they built this match well, and we get more build for the North American Championship with D-Jack attacking Wesley after he defeats Carmelo Hayes.
It's D-Jack!
Ooh.
D-Jack is back, and he just laid out the North American Champion.
This is something WWE has gotten better at a lot lately with Vince McMahon being out, is that they are actually making championships mean something again. And we're seeing that again here, much like the US title on the main roster, the North American Championship on NXT is also becoming more important. At number two was a story I was apprehensive about when it first started, and that was the feud between Bray Wyatt and LA Knight, because the pairing as a feud didn't really make a lot of sense to me, but it continues to be very entertaining. I think that it is because of the strength of the promos by both Bray Wyatt and LA Knight. Bray Wyatt cut, in my opinion, his best promo since returning this past week on SmackDown.
I know that people really just want to see the monster. People just want to see the fiend. And that's it, right? You want to see the monster, right? You want to see the show, right? So come on, come on. See the human tornado destroy himself and everything around him, and that's all good and fine, but that's not the man that I want to be anymore.
Further explaining his story of he doesn't want to be this monster anymore. He knows that's what everybody thinks of him as, and he knows that's what everybody wants him to be, but he doesn't want to be that person anymore, and he's saying he is not responsible for the attack on LA Knight. LA Knight comes right back and cuts a great promo against Bray Wyatt and his asshole heel self also being entertaining.
How was your Thanksgiving? Did you enjoy it? Oh, good for you, because I didn't get to. Because 7 days ago, as I'm leaving the arena, just minding my own business, next thing I know, I end up getting pulled out from underneath a pile of Bray.
A pile of what?
A pile of trash.
I thought you just said a pile
of... Exactly. I knew you'd see it my way. And now that human trash bag gets to stand out there, vomit his lies to the world.
And then LA Knight is attacked again. Plus in the video, flashed, of course, for Bray Wyatt to be his mysterious self. There was a phone number in that video, and if you called the phone number, you'd get Bray Wyatt's psychiatrist, apparently. And talking about how Bray Wyatt is a danger to people.
The patient would need to think as highly of a medical practitioner as they do themselves, and honestly, that seems to border on the impossible. I've become concerned that this patient is such a danger to themselves and anyone they encounter that... Hello?
So they continue to build up this Bray Wyatt story very well, despite him not having any matches since his return. I don't know where they're going with this LA Knight feud, but it is entertaining at least, and that is because both men are great at promos.
So what do you think happens when you do that and you piss Roman off? What do you think he's going to do to you? You've seen what he does to his own blood when they piss him off, so what's going to happen to you? Just think about that.
But number one continues to be the best story in pro wrestling, and that is the Bloodline and the Bloodline dynamic with Sami Zayn. This past week with Kevin Owens trying to get in Sami Zayn's head that he needs to turn on the Bloodline before the Bloodline turns on him. This has also continued the dynamic between Sami Zayn and Jey Uso, Jey Uso being the one most suspicious about what Sami Zayn's intent with the Bloodline actually is.
I will not let you down any night.
But during the actual War Games match, Sami Zayn did nothing but save the Bloodline throughout the match. He also saved Roman Reigns from being pinned by stopping the referee's 3 count when Kevin Owens was about to beat him in the match. And then he kicks his old friend Kevin Owens in the balls and helps Bloodline win the match. In the end, Sami Zayn is embraced by Roman Reigns. He's even embraced by Jey Uso.
Family, that's the Bloodline, and it's an embrace by Jey Uso.
Meaning Sami Zayn is now officially a member of the Bloodline. Perhaps he really is Sami Uso now, which is what the crowd chanted all night. It's been a great story and continues to have so many legs. They have so many directions they can go in with this Bloodline story. It's dynamic, and I think it continues to be the best thing in pro wrestling.